Okay, this problem deals with the sizing of a packed bed reactor. In this reaction, we're dealing with an A plus B gives C reaction, which is the hydrogenation of ethylene to ethane. And this reaction occurs over a solid catalyst in a packed bed tubular type reactor. And we're assuming that it follows elementary kinetics, and you're given information about the rate constant and the temperature. And part A asks you to ignore the pressure drop and to basically size the reactor to determine the mass of the nickel-based catalyst that's needed in order to get a conversion of 70% under the given conditions. And then in part B, we'll go back and look at what effect pressure drop might have for a particular situation where we change the flow rate. Okay, but to start off with, we're going to have a material balance. And again, we've started these in many different forms, but we have a packed bed reactor that we need to write our material balance for. And the way that we've commonly written this is that the mass of catalyst that's needed is equal to the inlet flow rate of component A, the species for which we're writing this material balance, integrated from the inlet condition, which is no conversion, to a conversion of X, and that this is equal to dx over negative RA. All right, so we're going to need to solve that material balance in order to solve for the catalyst mass. All right, but first we're going to need to know what the reaction rate of A is, the kinetics, or as if it's elementary. And so that means that we'll have a K times a concentration of A to the first power times the concentration of B to the first power. All right, and then the only thing that we need to do is that we have our integrating with respect to X in this expression, reaction rate expression in terms of concentration. And so we're going to need to express the concentration of A and the concentration of B in terms of conversion. Okay, and there's one-to-one stoichiometry here, so the first part of this is simple, right? The concentration of A, for example, is equal to the molar flow rate of A at the inlet times 1 minus x for conversion, divided by the volumetric flow rate V. All right, but the volumetric flow rate is also a function of the conversion because the number of moles that's going through the reactor actually decreases with conversion. All right, so we have 2 moles of reactants on one side and 1 mole of product on the other. And so for every mole of A that reacts, we lose 1 reactants. And so we've often referred to this parameter as delta A is equal to -1. Right, and then if we assume, for example, that let's assume that all of the A that's initially fed is converted. Right, we initially are feeding equimolar amounts of A and B. Right, if all of the A is converted, then if we started with 2 moles, we'll only have 1 left. Right, and whereas if half of the A is converted, if we started with 2 moles, we'd have 1.5 left, for example. And so we can derive an expression for this that is in terms of 1 plus epsilon A in Vogler notation times x, where epsilon A is equal to delta A times YA naught, which is equal to 0.5 because the feed consists of half A, that's the mole fraction. And so therefore epsilon A would be equal to -1 times 0.5, which is -0.5. And we can see that that's true because if we plug in the value of x, which is 1, the volumetric flow rate will go down to half of its original value as the moles are cut in half above, according to the ideal gas law, all right, as we go to full conversion. And the same, you can do other test cases, for example, for half conversion. All right, and so epsilon A here is equal to -0.5, and we'll just plug that in below. And we'll simplify and note that this value is equal to CA naught. Okay, the next, we also need to solve for the concentration of B. And we have equimolar concentrations of A and B. B is consumed at the same rate as A, and so CB is always equal to CA. Everywhere we can replace CB with CA whenever it comes up. Okay, and so we can now plug this into our rate expression, that this is equal to K times CA squared, or K times CA naught squared, times 1 minus X, where X is the conversion, divided by 1 minus 0.5X. Right, so this is our expression for concentration in terms of conversion, and we can now use that and we can now integrate that expression to solve for the catalyst mass. Okay, we're going to need a couple of constants in order to do that we don't have yet. One of those being the concentration, inlet concentration of A is not a given parameter, but we can use the ideal gas law again to get that. We have YA naught times P divided by RT. And YA naught, as we just discussed, is 0.5, that the inlet mole fraction of A is 1/2 because we have an equimolar full feed with B. The pressure is given as 5 atmospheres. R, we can use the 0.082 value, which I should put units on. The temperature is 400 Kelvin and is isothermal, as is given in the problem statement. And therefore, the inlet concentration of A is 0.076 per liter. All right, now we can go back to our expression for that we need to integrate and start plugging things in. Catalyst mass is equal to, right, so we can factor out a few constants, so we can pull out the K over CA naught squared. Okay, and now we just need to look up in an integral table some of these parameters. I'll just point out this is something you can also just solve with a integrating calculator. And there is an analytical solution. The volumetric flow rate is 8 liters per second. K is given as being 0.2 liters squared per second kilogram. And the concentration of A we just solved for, right, that is 0.076 moles per liter. So we have everything we need to solve for the catalyst mass. If you look in the in a common integral table, right, this quantity ends up being the constant in front ends up being 526 kilograms of catalyst. And then this integrand, if you evaluate it on a calculator, as I was lazy and did, ends up being 1.36. You can also find formulas for this in for example, the backup Vogler or in a common calculus textbook. In this case, the total catalyst mass will end up being 716 kilograms. Okay, in part B, we're told that the pressure drop down the reactor will be 0.5 atmosphere. All right, we're not going to end up needing to use that data. But this would tend up the pressure drop, which we haven't accounted for, is going to tend to increase the molar flow rate as we go down the reactor and lower the effective residence time in the reactor, and therefore lead to less conversion. The pressure drop will have a deleterious effect, and so another engineer at your company suggests that cutting entering volumetric flow rate in half will increase the conversion and lower the pressure drop. All right, so what you want to do is evaluate this claim. All right, the first issue that we'll consider is the pressure drop. All right, it's currently 0.5 atmosphere, and if we have our packed bed reactor, straight a packed bed full of particles, and if we lower the flow rate, so we're just decreasing V naught. You can plug this into the Ergen equation and see what the effect is, but we won't actually bother to do that because you can think about it purely conceptually. If you decrease the volumetric flow rate, then you lower the average velocity of the stream that's going through here, right? And therefore, you're going to lower the frictional losses as the stream goes around the catalyst particles. Right, so you're lowering friction because the velocity is going to be lower. So you're not having to force as much fluid through this catalyst bed. And therefore, the delta P, the pressure drop as we go across the catalyst bed, is actually going to go down. So you'll have less pressure drop as a result of this. And because the pressure drop goes down, all right, that effect should make the conversion go up. But there's another effect that's likely to be larger, and that's that also, as we cut the volumetric flow rate, the space-time goes up. So again, space-time is equal to the volume divided by the volumetric flow rate. We're not changing the volume of the reactor or the amount of catalyst. We're just decreasing the volumetric flow rate. And so the space-time goes up. And that means that the reaction is going to have a longer amount of time to occur inside the reactor. And that also is going to make the conversion go up. So both because the delta P is going to go down and because the effective space-time is going to go up since we decreased the volumetric flow rate, we're going to have an increase in the conversion. All right, but there's never a free lunch. There's always a trade-off for this. And the trade-off is that we will be producing fewer pounds of C. All right, so we're not feeding A and B as quickly. We're able to react them to higher conversion as a result of that. All right, but the total amount of the product that we make is going to go down because we're just not flowing as much through our reactor and we're allowing what's in there to stay in for longer. All right, so we can't produce C at as fast a rate.